This is Sarah Seeds outside the NYCLA getting ready to see Jagger do his thing in front of 300 people. Let's go inside.
About this event. It is going to be huge. And another thing, Jagger is totally awesome. I have to totally do more research about him, but I love him.
Welcome to the NYCLA. Do you have any, what do you think of Jagger having an event at the prestigious NYCLA?
Actually, I thought it was the biggest joke because he's a lunatic. So, I thought I was like having hidden cameras around or something. Thought it was like on candid camera. But I see that it's really going on and he's really here doing this and I can't wait to see the end result.
I think Jagger is enormous. Jagger is an incredible human being. He is one of the most talented teachers of acting that I have ever encountered. His classes are phenomenal. That he has decided to put together something regarding acting and the law is something that all of us in the profession of actors need to know, because there's so many legal pitfalls.
For a panel about agents, managers, and entertainment lawyers. So tell me about this and your role.
Oh my God, I think it's amazing. That's why I had to be here. I think it's really cool. It's out of the box, and you know me, I like to think out of the box, right?
So yes, perfect.
It's great.
Do you expect any surprises from the big man?
Oh, God, yeah, there's already been surprises. And I think it's going to be an evening of surprises.
Those cards back there are sitting on the seats. Great.
Okay, well, I think we're going to go ahead and get started. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Monica Trombley. I am the subcommittee chair of entertainment and media for the EMIPS committee here at NYCLUB. And I'm also the person who put together this event this evening. So that's who I am. And the moderator is the one, the only, Dr. Kaye.
What's up, kids? How are you? Oh, this is a nightmare for people, me with a mic. This is cool. First of all, thank you all for being here. Thank you, Angela, for picking up my pen. Let's begin with something very important, and then we'll get to the festivities. So please get out your pens, your paper, if you need to write stuff down. You can type it into your i-whatever, your Android, or your cloud, whatever you do. So take a second, because I think everybody needs to write this down. Okay, cool. You ready? Tonight's after seminar drunkard would be held at a bar called the Raccoon Lodge. Located at 59.
No, I just went on an audition for this show and I don't. And it always comes down to you can break it. There's a big brainstorm. You can break it. You don't have to adhere to the terms of any contract. You just have to be willing to accept the repercussions. Nothing's going to happen if you don't go on the cruise ship. You're just never going to work with that cruise ship again. Word's going to spread around that this person,
or that casting director,
or the casting director, or the agent that booked you the role. My point of view as a lawyer is, I'll do whatever you want. You want to break the contract, that's what you're hiring me to do, and I will use my legal mind and try to find a loophole, and or I'll explain to you, just so you understand, if you do this, this is what's going to happen. So you can break the contracts, and it does happen, but you just need to understand
the repercussions.
You can't just get out of contracts and walk away.
Right.
You're gonna hurt someone, and it's gonna in general potentially hurt your reputation. But in some cases, people are willing to hurt their reputation because of a bigger opportunity. If you have a signed contract to be Tom Cruise's co-star in the next movie, break the cruise ship contract.
Yeah.
Handled that.
I called the agent up and I said, "Hello, why didn't you cast? You know, why didn't you submit this actor? I want to cast them." And they're like, "Oh well, we didn't know."
And then that agent calls the actor and goes, "I worked my ass off to get you this role."
Right. Well, that's my point. And then they're asking me for all plus 10 and this and that and all the perks, and I'm like, "Are you kidding me? I got the job." No, it happens sometimes. I had an agent once tell me
this is a true story, and I'm not going to mention it, any names. But he said, he called me, I called, and he never returned the call. And this is with a big Hollywood actor, too, so apparently he bypassed his agent for somehow, and he did a film for me, and the agent finally called back like 2 weeks later, and he's like, oh, I'm going to tell you right now, we're passing on your project. I'm like, really? Your actor's on my set.
Wow. No matter what, you need to double-check and double-check. One word that is missed in a contract can be the difference between you making money or losing
yes.
millions, quote-unquote. And so you really got to make sure. And another key point is, remember, her lawyer and Jerry's lawyer is not whose lawyer?
Your lawyer.
So just because there's a lawyer in the room who seems to be chummy and talking with you and sounds like, oh, it's all good, don't worry. They legally should be obligated to tell you, look, I represent Donna. I don't represent you. Sometimes they just don't do that. And, you know, there are sleazy attorneys, believe it or not. And can you mention any names?
No. Gary Don Kelly, he was a director of One Life to Live When I Know I'm Just Getting Some Love. And he also directed the music. Come on, Gary, thank you so much. And then I'm going to have Brett. Is there anything as well? So Gary, come up. Was there anything that we were discussing that you'd like to add on? Or is there something, maybe a question you'd like to ask?
As you said, I live, you know, in the blissful world of artists as a director for a lot of years. I had an agent. Every couple of years, I was on this great show. And we'd get together, and he would handle the things. And I'd go, okay, that sounds good. And I would read the contract, finally. But, you know, I didn't really read the contract. Because people were taking care of it for me. This last year, the soap ended, I started producing a film, Jagger was in it, and they also helped on the film. And all of a sudden, I was wearing a different hat. You know, I was wearing a producer's hat. And one of my friends, who was a producer, who I went to for guidance, said, get the best lawyer you can. Here's this guy, Evan is his name. Call him, okay? He may cost you money, but you know what? It won't cost you money at the other end if you get Evan, okay? And at the time, you know, I'm glad that I went that extra yard, because when it came down to what they're talking about, which was each of the producers in the thing had an attorney, each investor that we had an attorney, you know, everyone involved in the whole freaking thing had an attorney, okay? And what was really great was I had a good one.
One of my favorite people in the world is Brett Goldstein. Please stand up. See me, Brett Goldstein.
And lawyers do for me as a casting director. That helps so much. I'm not a contract lawyer. It's not my background. I have a BA in theater from the University of Maryland. So one of the things that's helped me so much is that when, for example, Don Buchwald, which is the agency that Jerry used to work at, their in-house legal team, they've gone through my deal memos with a fine-tooth comb, and they've created wording for different line items in the deal memo that I could never come up with on my own. What's the result of that? It protects the actors.
Right, well, they should be like, hey, I really need my, you know, my agent to take a look at this before I can sign it. And they'll always be like, oh no, it's fine, just sign it.
I think that's the push and shove.
Well, then don't do the work, because they're already on set, and they're not gonna hire someone else on set, and they're not gonna get anyone to do
it. Just the other point, just from a legal point of view, I mean, that's technically called duress. And so, say that again, the legal term is duress. And okay. So if somebody forces you to sign something without, you need to have the right to now, what consult would you, with an agent or...
That I get, but what exactly is, like, who judges when it becomes duress? Because they'll always say, oh no, we weren't pushing it.
What he just said, those words that yeah. Jerry just said, are, that's the...
Oh, I've been in duress all day, I have no clue.
I do, like if somebody's on set, I will tell them, take a picture with your phone and send it.
That's
to
a great idea.
That's exactly what I have them do. So while they're there, I'm like reading it really quick through, you know. So.
Everybody at CNC, everybody on the panel. My friends, thank you. Give yourself some love.
Good advice, very generous with their advice and their stories and insights. And it was really great. And Jagger obviously is a very forceful.
Bizarre. No, wait. It's on camera? Wait.
He's a
special.
He's just a very special moderator.
He's got a different kind of energy that he brings, you know.
He brings it.
I like how he puts people in line. I think that's my favorite thing.